The president's touting an unusual announcement from the Department of Justice about, quote, discarded ballots in Pennsylvania. Can you just explain what he's talking about now? And also, I mean, is the Department of Justice basically a part of the Trump campaign now?
Well, I mean, you know, opinions vary on that front, Anderson, and we're going to have to see how this plays out in the coming weeks. But I don't think this was a welcome sign today, just on the face of it. Earlier in the day, the president was on Fox Radio talking about how ballots for President Trump were found in a trash can. Then Kayleigh McEnany at the White House briefing was talking about nine Trump ballots in Pennsylvania that were discarded. And then all of a sudden, the Justice Department puts out a press release talking about this. What is unusual about this, Anderson, not that the Justice Department would investigate election fraud or allegations of election fraud or discarded ballots. It's the fact that it was made public to the American people that these were Trump ballots. It was as if people inside the Justice Department were trying to furnish the president, his team here at the White House, the Trump campaign, with sort of an aha, we got him sort of moment. When in fact, these kinds of episodes, these anecdotal pieces of evidence that come across from time to time that there might be election fraud going on, they have to be investigated. And that's what the Democratic Attorney General of Pennsylvania was saying, was that this was an example of the system working. They found a case where something needed to be investigated. But Anderson, the fact that the Justice Department would put out a press release saying that, oh, by the way, we found some, we're investigating some Trump ballots that were discarded, I think that raises some alarm bells. And obviously, this is a case that people are going to be closely watching. One wrinkle we should point out, Anderson, is that the Justice Department initially put their press release on its website talking about this case, then had to pull it down because the number of ballots in question here went from 9 to 7, and they had to correct themselves in putting out that press release, almost seeming as if they were racing out there to get the president some helpful information and then had to go back and correct the record, Anderson.
Jim Acosta, thanks. Perspective now from Colorado Secretary of State Jenna Griswold, who will oversee elections in her state, which mails ballots to every voter. Also CNN Chief Legal Analyst and former federal prosecutor Jeffrey Toobin. Secretary Griswold, what do you make of the Department of Justice announcing details of an inquiry like this?
Well, I think the investigation is still very unclear, and we'll see what happens as the details develop. But what is clear is that the president is using his position as president to try to tilt an election in his favor. It seems that the use of the DOJ is to try to undermine mail ballots even further because the president believes that at least the use of mail ballots in some states will hurt his political chances. And I just really urge Americans to ignore what the president is saying on vote by mail. He is lying to try to keep power. And what Americans should do is just make sure their registration is up to date, vote a mail ballot if it's available in the jurisdiction, and make a plan to vote early and make all of our voices heard this upcoming election.
Jeff, I mean, is there any precedent for something like this? For a president doing this? Is it for what the Department of Justice is doing?
Well, no and no. I mean, it's important to realize that one of the bedrock principles of the Justice Department is you don't release partial information about an investigation that is just getting started. This is something every assistant U.S. attorney learns, that you don't tell the press that you're looking into subject A, B, or C. What you do is you issue a press release when the case is resolved, usually with an indictment or sometimes when you decide not to indict. But to release that you are investigating, you know, possible tampering or some sort of improper conduct, it's all so vague that you can't even tell what really went on here. It looks like, I think, as you suggested, this was a Trump campaign press release in the form of a Department of Justice letter from a U.S. attorney, and it is really a tremendous embarrassment that the Justice Department has started to behave this way. But I think you can see why. It's because the president is trying to undermine the election in general and mail-in ballots in particular.
Secretary Griswold, I mean, if 7 ballots were found in the garbage, why would that happen? I mean, in your state, what sort of, you know, I mean, is there, you know, the claims by the president, obviously, is that this validates the idea that there is widespread organized voter fraud with mail-in ballots and certainly universal ballots.
Well, I think it's really important to highlight study after study shows that the rate of any type of voter fraud is extremely low. You can just look at the Heritage Foundation, the conservative think tank, that puts the rate of voter fraud at 0.00006% with mail ballots. So I really do believe this is a political stunt. This is not the first time that the president has tried to use federal agencies to bolster his crusade against this election. And I want to underline how dangerous this is for the nation. We have a president who is not committing to respect the outcomes of our elections. We need to make sure that every American is ready to go to the polls and equipped with the information that they need, because every American needs to have their voice heard if they're eligible to vote. And we cannot let the president sow so much confusion and discord into our elections that it ends up suppressing turnout come November.
Jeff, and the Department of Justice also, as we mentioned, commented on which candidates, seven of the ballots, cast their vote for. Is that something the DOJ would usually do?
Never. And the U.S. attorney wrote this two-page letter. It is so unclear what even happened here. One of the reasons you don't release preliminary information as a prosecutor is because it is incomplete and sometimes mysterious in what it actually means. So the idea that there was some sort, it's not even clear that what went on here. And the fact that, you know, that they mentioned that these were seven or seven out of nine or nine out of nine, again, it's vague, Trump ballots, underlines that this was not a legitimate law enforcement operation to release this information. It was simply a stunt to help the president discredit mail-in balloting. And this is precisely what the Justice Department should not be doing.
Secretary Griswold, I mean, you're obviously on the front lines of this. Where does the state of Colorado stand with the mail-in voting process? And I'm wondering how confident you are it's working in your state.
Well, in Colorado, we have the national gold standard when it comes to elections, and we mail a ballot to every registered voter. And I am tremendously confident in the ability to have a great election in November. There was a back and forth with the Postmaster General. He has given assurances that the Postal Service is up to the task. But more importantly, we've won a couple lawsuits making sure that the postage and mail ballots are delivered in a timely fashion. But I am concerned about the president's rhetoric, that we have a president who disrespects the very foundation of our democracy. And unfortunately, we do not have the legal guardrails in place to ensure that our elections go so that every American can have their voice heard. So what I hope is that after this election, we continue a national conversation. A conversation to make sure that every American's right to vote is respected. And that means vote by mail for all, early voting, same day voter registration, and access for every American across the nation, just like we have here in Colorado.
So are you getting any sense, though, that the president's scare tactics about mail-in voting is giving voters in Colorado any second thoughts about the system's integrity?
Well, the president has a huge platform, and I think it's just such a shame for the nation and confidence in our elections that he chooses to use it for corruptive purposes. I will say in our June 30th primary, we set a record turnout. 99.3% of all ballots were cast using a mail ballot, even with the opportunity to use in-person early voting and election day in-person voting, and that a higher percentage of Republican voters chose to use their mail ballot. We are getting an increased number of calls asking about how the process will work. And we're trying the best, I'm trying my best to push back against the lies. And that's why I think it's so important to have these conversations so that Americans know that the president is spewing lies for his own political gain and that they should continue to make a plan and cast a ballot